on your favorite Arkansas sports talk station.
And this one belongs to the Razorbacks.
Streaming live from
HitThatLine.com. Fans are amazing. It is lit down here on the sideline.
This is Halftime with Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett.
My calculations are correct. When this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're going to see some serious...
Here come the students. Oh, here come the students. They're coming from the south end, and this one has been a long time brewing.
I have been waiting for this moment for a long time.
Judging by the sound of it, so has everyone else.
Hey, hold on. It's almost halftime.
Well, sometimes in the game of baseball, you just got to pick yourself up and worry about the very next day. The thing is that unless you win tonight, there is no very next day. The very next day would be packing the bags and headed home and looking forward to the next baseball season. But, yeah, disappointing outcome last night for sure. And, I mean, not even a close game, which I guess plays exactly to the way every game in the College World Series has played out so far. Has been a lot of drama in these games, there wasn't a lot of drama after the fifth inning yesterday when Ole Miss pulled away for a 13-5 victory over the Razorbacks to send Arkansas to an elimination game tonight against the Auburn Tigers. So lots to hash out over these next couple of hours, and we appreciate you joining us on Halftime. I'm Phil Elson. I'm at DJ's Dugout once again. Been here for the last four shows. Drew Barrett and Matty T at the ESPN Arkansas headquarters. And guys, we're back to being surrounded by Aggies for the second time since I've been here. I've even been nice enough to give up my seat on the stage where they've had me the days that Arkansas plays.
Yeah, I noticed so there's a different angle there.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just sitting off to the side. I'm just like another paying customer who brought radio equipment and a computer and a scorebook and a backpack and everything else that goes into a radio show. So I'm just a regular not paying customer today.
Are we even being broadcast for all them to hear today?
No, we are not. I'm not going to let them hear all the things that we say about Texas A&M.
They can't hear how much they suck right now.
That's right. You want to let them know then? Well, hey, we already did all of our A&M jokes the other day. We already got in all of our Texas A&M jokes. I think that was Friday when they went over to play there. So, yeah, I mean, they've got the first elimination game. It's A&M and Notre Dame at 1 o'clock, and then it's Arkansas versus Auburn at 6 o'clock. What to start with yesterday? Arkansas pitching just kind of fell apart. And part of that also goes into the idea that the Mississippi lineup is just really good right now, and it's unfortunate that the pitching couldn't necessarily hold them down very much. And it's funny when you look at things, how things can play out, and who knows what would have happened, but the very first at-bat of the game just kind of gave you a little bit of an idea, maybe, of what could happen, because Zach Morris, who I still think, I think it's so easy to criticize the choice of a starting pitcher.
Obviously, hindsight 2020, it's easy to do it now.
It's so easy to criticize this.
But doesn't he gets mean ahead you of should though. I mean, that's the point I think you're about to try to make, because
that's what I mean.
With the statistics in front of all of us, we would have done the exact same thing.
Yeah, yeah. But he gets ahead of Justin Bench 0-2, throws two good fastballs, and then throws him another good fastball, but it was too good, and Bench lines a single. The next thing you know, Jacob Gonzalez hits a high chop, a routine ground ball to a middle infielder. You're going to get a double play at that point. A high chop moved Bench up to second base. And a couple of batters later, the onslaught begins with the single by Kevin Graham on the first pitch and then three walks in a row. And it looked for a minute that Arkansas might be able to keep up with the scoring from Ole Miss. You know, they scored three runs in the first couple of innings, but those really were gift runs.
Yeah, you got pretty lucky. You had a few muffed balls by the shortstop. Obviously, the sun was deadly in left field yesterday. So you scored the initial three. And I know you finished the game with five in kind of a junk time situation, home double, two-run home run in the ninth inning. But you kind of were lucky to score the initial three, which what you had. And going back to that bench at-bat, the first two pitches that Zach Morris threw were on the outside corner, low, perfect ball placement, perfect strikes. Now, what he was trying to do, this is something that you see pitchers do all the time. It's very textbook, very 0-2 style of pitching. You never want to give up a hit on an 0-2 count. I mean, that's a cardinal rule of baseball.
And so it happened a couple of times last night.
Yeah, so what he's trying to do is he's gone outside, low and outside both times. All right? So now what he's trying to do is change the batter's eye level. What he's trying to do is get the ball up, possibly get it a little bit closer to him, so that way if he decides to come back low and outside again the next pitch, the bench's eyes isn't going to be trained on it because he just saw two straight pitches. It's a easy trick of a way to be able to attack a batter with the same pitch, just in a different sequence, and they won't be able to touch it, just to kind of throw them off a bit. And what the problem was, when you change the eye level, it needs to be above the shoulders, not right at the letters.
Yeah,
that's what happened.
Too good of an 0-2 pitch, but it wasn't even just Morris, as Mr. Pip texts in here. I mean, you had seven pitchers get out there yesterday, and five of them allowed multiple runs in less than an inning and a third. So it wasn't all on Morris, because he was gone seven batters into the game. Evan Taylor had trouble slowing him down. Cole Ramage couldn't slow him down. Jackson Wiggins couldn't do it. And they scored three off of Gabe Starks. So, I mean, pitching has been a big strength in the recent games in the tournament. Arkansas allowed a total of 9 runs in the previous 4 games against North Carolina, against Oklahoma State, and Stanford. 9 runs in the previous 4 games. So you really couldn't have seen that coming yesterday. But there is something about the way that Ole Miss is putting games together and the way that their pitcher threw. Hunter Elliott just kind of gave a class on how to pitch. He just kept batters off balance for most of his 6 1/3 innings. And another good text here coming in from Tim. It's not the choice of the starting pitcher that's the issue. It's that right now you don't have very many options of starting pitchers who have had a lot of experience starting games. There's Connor Noland. And then your second most experienced starting pitcher after that is Will McIntyre. Really, it's Cole Ramage. Cole hasn't started a game in a couple of years. it's Will McIntyre who's made 3 or 4 starts, or maybe 5 starts in his career. And then Morris yesterday was his second. So this does show a little bit of the effect on the depth of the starting pitching with the injury to Peyton Paulette. And here it is. It's 6 months after the injury was even reported, and he had his surgery, and he's recovering. But it does show, you know, the starting rotation hasn't necessarily grown as the season's gone along. Guys in the bullpen have grown. McIntyre certainly has emerged. But you're in a situation that and it's obviously so difficult to go through the loser's bracket and try to win 3 consecutive games, especially when you're going to face a team, if you win today in Ole Miss, that gets an extra day of rest. But you've got to have depth of pitching and starting pitching specifically to at least extend the game a little bit. And I'm not exactly sure how you extend things once you get past today. Hopefully you do. There's plenty of pitching for today, Drew. Plenty.
Yeah, I mean, there is. I mean, you got Will McIntyre ready to lock and load it. I think that 99% of us all agree that's probably where Dave Van Horn's going to go with the ball. Then you've got Hagen Smith, who has done a great job coming into relief, giving you two solid innings in most of his outings this postseason. And then, of course, you've got the closer all season, Brady Tigert, who is obviously 100% fresh. So you're not worried about today. The problem is, what do you do tomorrow? What do you do Thursday if you're lucky enough to make it that far? And when you talk about Peyton Paulette, he came up in some conversations last night. I was with some friends watching the game, and we were talking about, you know, even if Paulette was just half as good as we all thought and expected him to be, just to have one more arm that you could count on 3-4 more innings to be thrown, it could have changed everything last night. Because, you know, once Zach Morris didn't work out, and then you had to go to the pen, then you had to go to Evan Taylor, and then to Cole Ramage, and then you're kind of really starting to have to backpedal there, because you got to realize there's baseball still left to be played. So you've got to figure out a way to try to stop the bleeding, and I think that's what Dave Van Horn did. I think if he could go back, he might have kept Evan Taylor in for an extra inning. He might have stayed with Cole Ramage a little bit longer, but he was trying to just buy his offense some time. He was trying to throw off that that very high-powered Ole Miss offense that we saw last night, just trying to buy time to get the bats going for Arkansas. And ultimately, when they didn't come, that's when you see Jackson Wiggins come in. That's when you see, you know, three other guys who combined, I think, had less than 35 innings pitched this season.
Yeah, Wiggins almost gave them what they really needed, Drew, which was two zeros in a row. Mm-hmm. You know, and you just look at the pitcher that came on the mound after Morris. Evan Taylor, he's given you three innings a few times this year, scoreless. Same with Cole Ramage. Mm-hmm. Jackson Wiggins had been a starting pitcher previously, so they were looking for somebody to string together a couple of scoreless innings, then maybe give him a third. That's what happens in a Johnny bullpen game like yesterday was going to be. And really, that's the case. I mean, when Zach Morris is the starting pitcher, it's basically a Johnny bullpen game. And it's nothing on Morris. It's just a matter of he's never gone any longer than three and a third innings in his career. You're not asking him to go four or five innings as a starting pitcher, so it's all relief. Today's different. McIntyre, he's a guy that can get you into the sixth inning. And we'll see how that works out. But there's plenty of pitching ready to go, as you've already listed them off, Drew. So, and then the other option would be, you know, when you win, if you win today, well, who pitches tomorrow in a must-win game?
You got to go back
to
Connor,
face a
don't
winner
you?
Cave takes all, and it's probably Connor Nolan. That's exactly right. He only threw in the 70 to 75 pitch range on Saturday, so he didn't get overworked. But first things first, win this game, and then you'll get to tomorrow.
Yeah, that's the main thing. And I just want to add, because you've said it 1,000 times, everybody wants to try to pick out different examples, different reasons why yesterday didn't work. You've said it 1,000 times, Phil, and I'm just here to sing your praises and give you credit where credit is due. It all starts with the starting pitcher, and your starting pitcher just didn't start last night, and it's hard to get that motor going when you basically flood the engine to start off the bat.
Yeah, but you live to fight another day, like I said. And, at least one thing that Arkansas leads in right now. And I've decided that I really don't care about the jello shot thing anymore.
I figured out,
like, it was a cute thing at first. Now, you're just getting price gouged for something that feels like a matter of pride. But all it is just flooding a specific restaurant bar in Omaha with tens of thousands of dollars. In which they're literally making a profit of like probably a 95% to near 100% profit margin of what they're doing. So I've stopped caring about the jello shot thing.
So many people struggling now, you know, struggling at the pump. And then you got people just wasting money on nonsense.
I saw a receipt for $4,500
worth of
jello shots yesterday.
That makes me angry.
Another one, $2,500. I mean, if you got it, you got it. But at the same time, like we talked about it yesterday. Up until yesterday, Arkansas fans had spent enough money to pay tuition, room, and board for a freshman student for an entire year of school at the University of Arkansas.
That could have been some good NIL money right there.
It could have been.
For a student-athlete, right? Yeah, get yourself with the Arkansas Razorback Collective. So, yeah.
I can't tell people how to spend it.
Right. I'm not going to tell anyone how to spend their money, but I can decide whether or not I care about what it is they're spending their money on. And Jello shots out of the College World Series ain't it right now.
They're not even homemade Jello shots.
I know.
They're prepackaged. Yeah.
I'd rather much have – I mean, the only Jello shot that's worth drinking is one that was made, you know, with grandma's favorite recipe.
Yeah.
Yeah, passed down from generation to generation.
I have a friend named Katina back in Memphis who is known as the Jello Shot Queen. She makes different flavors for different tailgates depending on the teams
Memphis is playing. Does she make like jigglers, Jello jigglers?
She puts gummies in them and everything. Oh, and they potent too. Four or five and you out.
Well, maybe at the college football championship we can have a pudding pop championship or something like that. I don't know. If you want to call or text halftime, 877-377-6963. Alyssa Orange will join us in a couple of segments. And then at 12:30, the voice of Auburn Athletics, Andy Burcham, will just walk right across the street from the Auburn Hotel, sit down here with us, and we'll hash out what might happen later on tonight when the Razorbacks and Auburn Tigers send one of those teams home. Stay with us on halftime here on this fabulous Tuesday in Omaha.
This is Toyota Tuesday on the Morning Rush. Get by your local Toyota dealer for a test drive today. Toyota, let's go places.
Together we stand as tall as the Tower of Old Maid. Our memories are etched in stone like names on senior walk, and our blood flows Razorback red. For 100 years we've been hog wild, and today we continue the tradition. We are Arkansas Razorbacks.
Listen to every Razorback football game this season right here on ESPN 95.3 and hitthatline.com.
Before you buy that next car or truck, stop by Broadway Motors in Van Buren, the best of the best for 2 straight years. Michael and his team offer the best prices on the best quality pre-owned vehicles in the River Valley. They invite you to stop by and check it out for yourself. Or if you prefer to check out their inventory online or even do your financing online. Michael has built his reputation as a husband, father, and owner-operator since 2006. Broadway Motors, 806 Broadway in Van Buren, or online at BroadwayMotorsAR.com.
Arkansas Fuel Injection in Fort Smith has been providing quality work for all new and rebuilt diesel pumps and injectors for over 25 years. They are a certified diesel shop with a team of quality technicians that ensure the highest quality workmanship and warranties all their work. They're open Monday through Friday, 8 to 5, and has emergency service available 24 hours a day. For all your diesel pump, fuel injection, and parts need, stop by Arkansas Fuel Injection, 6300 South 29th Street, Fort Smith. Call them today at 1-800-817-7709. Arkansas Fuel Injection.
Van Alma Tire Center is always right around the corner from you with all the major brand tires for you to choose from. Bridgestone, Firestone, Cooper, and more. Turn into Van Alma Tire Center for all your tire needs, alignments, oil changes, brakes, and more. With service you can depend on, Van Alma Tire Center is your one-stop shop for all your vehicle and tire needs. Right around the corner at 6805 Alma Highway, 5 miles east of Van Buren and 2 miles west of Alma.
Stop by your locally owned TGI Fridays at I-540 and Rogers in Fort Smith, where it's happy hour all day, every day. Stop by anytime and try our $4 cocktails. Choose from a Bloody Mary, Cape Cod, Tequila Sunrise, Whiskey Sour, and more. There's also $5 glasses of wine, and Miller Lite 12-ounce drafts are always just $2. Get to TGI Fridays for lunch Monday through Friday for our $9.99 burger deal, available until 3 p.m. and comes with fries and a soft drink, tea, or Miller Lite draft. Order online for pickup at Fridays.com.
Great people, great equipment, great opportunities. That is what you get at Patriot Transport, based in Centerville, Arkansas, with locations in Russellville and Van Buren, with regional OTR and local opportunities for qualified CDL drivers. Make up to $95,000 annually and be a part of a team that embraces the concept of family. Patriot Transport wants you to be successful on the road and at home, working with every driver to ensure they get the miles they want and the family time at home they strive for. Patriot Transport, more than trucking, it's family. Visit PatriotTransport.com to apply.
Hell yes! Hey folks, Larry Rath here for Rath Auto Resources, where we've just had the perfect storm. Yeah, we got hail, but just enough to create a tsunami of savings for our customers. That's right, little bitty damage and great big old savings on a great selection of Rath Road Ready vehicles. But you want to hurry in for the best selection, because this inventory is turning like a tornado. If you have damage on your car, bring it in. We'll trade for it just like it is, even if it looks like a Titleist. If you're keeping your car, let us take care of it for you in our Meineke Car Care Center with free AC check, half off brakes, and buy three, get one free on all tires. Better yet, trade it in and say hell yes to this perfect storm of savings. Don't wait till they're all fixed. Don't wait till they're all gone. Start driving better today during the hell yes sale at Arkansas' favorite used car dealer, Rath Auto Resources and the Meineke Car Care Center, 4515 Towson Avenue, Fort Smith, or online, rathauto.com.
Your home for every Razorback football, basketball, and baseball game. ESPN 95.3. Hey, the Hogs are back in the College World Series, and ESPN Arkansas and HitThatLine.com are in Omaha. Our daily live coverage of the Hogs and the College World Series is presented by Crane Kia of Fayetteville. Find your next gas saver during our MPG days at Crane Kia of Fayetteville. When it's hot outside and your AC isn't cooling, avoid the hassle. Go Pascal. Schedule your service call today at GoPascal.com. Baptist Health. Amazing has a new home. Find a doctor near you at BaptistHealth.com.
way.
Yeah, I think he only threw, what, 39 pitches yesterday, yeah. 2 2/3?
You don't have the same feeling about Auburn that you do about Ole Miss, do you?
No.
The negativity, well, let's just go with, like, my radio partner for baseball games. You can hear Bubba's dislike of Ole Miss just dripping with every syllable that he speaks about them, even about the fans.
I was listening to y'all on my way to the station during the ninth inning, and I thought Bubba was going to blow a gasket, especially two outs, and it might have been the eighth inning. Eighth inning, two outs
for the hitters conference. Yeah.
Bianco growls him over for like 2 minutes. I thought Bubba was about to just dog cuss Mike Bianco on air.
Yeah, it's like, come on, man, come on. It was like Esker, the Stanford coach, calling for a review in the ninth inning, down 15 runs. Come on.
Speaking of Stanford, have they finished hugging? Have they finished hugging it out yet?
Yeah. You want to give a team that season ended a little bit of leeway, but that was a little bit ridiculous. Arkansas had to wait outside the third base dugout for like 7 to 10 minutes because Stanford took forever to finish their post-game huddle, and then like they literally hugged each other. Everybody hugged each other in the field. Then they went into the dugout and kept hugging and very slowly packed up the equipment. You could see the guys there. You know what it looks like when you're being waited on by somebody. Hands on hips, trying not to make it look like you're looking, and then all of a sudden, you got to look at them. They're like, all right, guys.
Enough is enough.
Out at the hotel.
You got plenty of time to hug it out. Palo Alto is it's pretty far of a plane ride. You can hug it out at 30,000 feet.
So they're done, and so is Texas. Bubba and I, when we walked out of the ballpark yesterday, we did get some Ole Miss fan was there on the telephone, and he decided to put his phone down, saw the two of us walk out, and shouted a hottie toddy right at us. We were like 20 feet away. I was not in the frame of mind at that moment to act very quickly, but I could have had a couple of choice words. I just said, cool, kept on walking. Can't stand the hottie toddy little thing. All right, let's go to Cody, who's giving us a call here. Hey, Cody, how are you?
Hey, I'm doing all right. I'm like the rest of the Hog Nation, and it's at least somewhat level-headed. It's frustrating because I think we've beaten Ole Miss the last 2 years as far as series goes. Then we beat them in the Super Regional. It's just frustrating because you hate to lose to Ole Miss. But, hey, every dog has their day, and they're just finally clicking at the right time. I don't know if Tommy Kraft said something that was really smart, and it was in reference to Razorback football season and the transition from football season to basketball season. And I wonder sometimes if us as Razorback baseball fans, because Dave Van Horn is so good at what he does, if we've just kind of made it to where we don't start paying attention to the Hogs or the Super Regionals or they're going to Omaha. If you look at it, Ole Miss was missing a couple key pieces. Well, they're back. And 1 through 9, that's about as good of an offensively hitting team as I've seen. What I've also realized is we don't have Paulette this year. You have Paulette, your Friday night starter. You have Nolan, your Saturday starter. And then you eventually iron out McIntyre, Wiggins, whoever you want to throw Sunday. And it's just one of those things where it's always a piece away or a step away. And what people understand is it's not as easy as saying, let's win a national championship. It's the hardest damn thing to do, especially in baseball. Drew, you played, you pitched. You know how hard it is. Wiggins looked good for a couple innings last night, but it's just one of those things to put it all together in baseball. It's almost impossible. But what do you guys think, positive? And I'm still real happy with the result of the Hawks, and hopefully we can win tonight and at least be competitive against Ole Miss. But it looks like Ole Miss and Oklahoma, and that's going to be a hell of a series. But y'all have a good one, and try to stay positive. They still have had a hell of a year.
Well, let's not make your plans for watching the Sooners and the Rebels just yet.
Still ain't out of it. I mean, and that's the thing. And I appreciate Cody's call and him being so level-headed. And I think if you scroll through Twitter last night, because Arkansas Twitter was pretty hectic last night, just to say the least. You can tell who's been watching this team all season long. You can tell who just now is starting to care or just now starting to put their Hog hat back on now that they are in Omaha, because you watched that game last night and you just know about college baseball in general and how good Ole Miss really is. I mean, they weren't picked preseason number one for nothing. I mean,
they
that is very
number
talented.
Number one a month into the season.
Yeah, it's a very
good team.
It's a talented, very good roster. And, you know, when it comes to Jackson Wiggins, the thing with him, and you'll hear it a lot, you can't teach 100 miles per hour. You can't. But you got to teach movement, man. That fastball, I mean, it is flat, and that's why you were able to get one good inning until the batters were able to pick it up, until they were able to get their hands quick enough and be able to attack the ball. You can only blow it by people so many times before they speed it up.
I feel for Wiggins. I really do, because he's incredibly talented. And as difficult as it is to throw 100 miles an hour, just imagine how difficult it is to control or command 100 miles an hour, even as straight as it is, and then trying to learn movement on it and command that. Like, I don't know what will happen with Wiggins in the future, and I'm even referring to, you know, if he's with the program another year. I have no inside info to give you about that, but I do know, like, there's been plenty of guys who've gone on to have major league careers that didn't figure it out in college because pitching is hard. Hitting is hard. Baseball is hard. A heck of a lot harder than it looks on television, and even a lot harder than it looks from sitting up in a radio booth 250 feet above home plate. It's a tough game to learn, and I don't know if there's anything that much tougher than learning how to throw a baseball that you have more talent in your right arm than most people have in their entire body when it comes to this sport, and trying to command 100 miles an hour. It's amazing that guys are actually able to do that anyway. It's so much easier than it looks.
I'm not saying it's easy by any means.
Or so much more difficult than it
looks. Once he is able to put some movement on it and be able to mix in some pitches and get some off-speed stuff, that he can control with pretty decent accuracy, he's going to be dangerous. It's just he's just got to figure out how to get that ball off such a flat plane.
It's a head-scratcher right now. It really is. All right, we'll step aside in just a moment here and joined by Alyssa Orange from Pigtro Nation. But first, if your mattress is lumpy or caved in or it's just old and you hate sleeping on it, well, you got to get over to Cheap Sleep. That's your number one stop for name brand mattresses at 75% off. They've got pillow top, hybrid, firm, medium, plush, bed in a box. They got it all. And living room sets as well. You can take home a new sofa or sectional for only $8.99 today. They have the largest same-day selection around, and they'll guarantee that you find something that you love at Cheap Sleep Furniture. They're located in Bentonville, Springdale, and Fort Smith, and open 7 days a week. Cheap Sleep Furniture. Stay tuned on Halftime, and Alyssa Orange from Pigtro Nation is with us next.
Memory down. Just remember her heart's on the mend. If you ever come back to see her again, don't ask her on a straight tequila night. She'll start thinking about him. Then she's ready to fight.
This is Toyota Tuesday on the Morning Rush. Get by your local Toyota dealer for a test drive today. Toyota, let's go places.
What does amazing sound like?
The company you can trust when it comes to building quality fencing and gates is looking for quality people to join the Fence Man team. If you are a fence builder or have building or welding experience, apply in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man offers great pay and a $500 sign-on bonus. Join the top fence building team and get a $500 sign-on bonus. The Fence Man. Apply today in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man is an equal opportunity employer.
Now that's a dandy white perch. Big old slab. C'est bon, succulent.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappie.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland, America's favorite. White perch, slab, succulent, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
This song was mistakenly thought to be about animal rights or shock therapy, but Shock the Monkey is really about jealousy. If we're just highly evolved primates, then why does adultery make us so irate? Natural selection would never make you hate someone who would seminate. It's because a supernatural God wired monogamy into our DNA. If you think this issue is benign, you'll be shocked to see Proverbs 6:29. I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Read about it.
DentSource, the leader in auto hail repair for over 20 years. Our certified technicians service all vehicles and offer a lifetime warranty. DentSource will keep you on the road with a courtesy vehicle and offer free pickup and delivery. DentSource, now open in Fort Smith.
The Fence Man, the company you can trust when it comes to building quality fencing and gates, is looking for quality people to join the Fence Man team. If you are a fence builder or have building or welding experience, apply in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man offers great pay and a $500 sign-on bonus. Join the top fence building team and get a $500 sign-on bonus. The Fence Man. Apply today in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man is an equal opportunity employer.
Now that's a dandy white perch. Big old slab. C'est bon, succulent.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappies.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland, America's favorite. White perch, slab, succulent, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
This song was mistakenly thought to be about animal rights or shock therapy, but Shock the Monkey is really about jealousy. If we're just highly evolved primates, then why does adultery make us so irate? Natural selection would never make you hate someone who would seminate. It's because a supernatural God wired monogamy into our DNA. If you think this issue is benign, you'll be shocked to see Proverbs 6:29. I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Read about it.
Dent Source, the leader in auto hail repair for over 20 years. Our certified technicians service all vehicles and offer a lifetime warranty. Dent Source will keep you on the road with a courtesy vehicle and offer free pickup and delivery. Dent Source, now open in Fort Smith.
The Fence Man, the company you can trust when it comes to building quality fencing and gates, is looking for quality people to join the Fence Man team. If you are a fence builder or have building or welding experience, apply in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man offers great pay and a $500 sign-on bonus. Join the top fence building team and get a $500 sign-on bonus. The Fence Man. Apply today in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man is an equal opportunity employer.
Now that's a dandy white perch. Big old slab. C'est bon!
Our daily live coverage of the Hogs in the College World Series is presented by Crane Kia of Fayetteville. Find your next gas saver during our MPG days at Crane Kia of Fayetteville. When it's hot outside and your AC isn't cooling, avoid the hassle. Go Pascal. Schedule your service call today at gopascal.com. Baptist Health. Amazing has a new home. Find a doctor near you at baptisthealth.com.
You're listening to Halftime with Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett. Want to jump in the conversation with the guys? Call or text into Halftime at 877-377-6963.
Alyssa Orange from Pictro Nation joining us on Halftime here. She was somewhere here in the Emerald City of college baseball. Busy day, I know for sure, and you got a ton to do. Where are you right now, Alyssa?
Currently sitting in the Pig Trail car on the way to downtown. We're going to try to jump out, do a noon hit, grab some lunch, and then there's this cool place up by Rosenblatt that I've heard. It's an old training collector's place. Have you heard of this, Bill? And you go in and they give you a beer when you walk through the door.
No. Is that a stadium shop? Is that a card shop that you're going to?
Yeah.
Okay, Stadium so View. I think that's what it's called.
Maybe, yeah, I think you're right, right across from the old Rosenblatt. So I think we're going to go up there and maybe talk to the owner.
Well, yeah, I think that's actually, that's a really famous place. And they've been able to stay in business even after the College World Series moved from Rosenblatt
right
down here to downtown. So, you live to fight another day, right? Dave Van Horn last night seemed pretty eager to move on to the next thing.
Yeah.
You got to answer questions about the game that just played and decisions and all of that kind of stuff. But today's the day, and Auburn's the thing. And right now, I think Arkansas is kind of set up pretty well for today as far as pitching's concerned. And the guy that they're facing I think they've had some success against. So, I mean, you lose to Ole Miss. Yeah. I think you got a really good shot against Auburn tonight.
Yeah, I think you do. And I think the biggest thing right now, and I'm sure you guys have talked about it, is you have Will McIntyre. We've seen what he's been able to do down the stretch here in the postseason. And he's a guy you can have some confidence in. I think the biggest thing, like with Dave last night, is like, look, you go with Zach Morris. He explained why he wanted to go with him over Will McIntyre yesterday. And so on paper, it made sense. It didn't work out. Sometimes decisions don't work out, and you can't dwell on it and try to second-guess yourself. And you kind of do what Stanford did, where you get the game gets so out of hand where you just start throwing some other guys that you knew normally wouldn't, and then you save some arm. So that's what we're doing today, and I think Will McIntyre can come out there and have a good showing. Obviously, what you want to see on the other side is Arkansas's offense starting to kind of get their groove back. This is the first game really in the postseason where this offense just didn't feel like they were in a rhythm at all. So you hope from an offensive standpoint they can get that going.
Yeah, I mean, and that's the other side of the coin here. I mean, you've displayed that you've been able to win slugfests in Stillwater and win low-scoring games in North Carolina. So, I mean, it seemed pretty easy to tell early that it wasn't going to be a low-scoring game on one side because no pitcher for Arkansas could slow down Ole Miss. But the you know, Ole Miss is pitching. That's the difference between Ole Miss now and then. You know, they might have lost Kevin Graham for a month, and that's a big deal because he's one of their top hitters. But their pitching has taken giant steps forward, and that was the difference yesterday. And you're exactly right about today. I mean, offensively, sometimes this team just needs to be carried by the bats. Last night was one of those nights. Hopefully tonight's not one of them.
Yeah. You would hope so. And, you know, everyone jokes like, oh, they scored 17 runs in that first game with Stanford, should have saved some. That baseball does not work like that. We all know baseball doesn't work like that. You can't just save runs in your back pocket. But you would hope that, you know, you kind of saw a little bit of it late. You know, they're hitting the ball hard. They're just right at guys. But I love, you know, the small ball approach with Zach Gregory and the bunt that scored the run there early on. Like, if you can manufacture runs, which we saw them do against North Carolina and against Oklahoma State, that is where you're going to win on the offensive scoreboard, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Alyssa, I think most people that have followed this team all season long, like all three of us have, you're feeling pretty confident tonight with the big bounce back, especially with the guys that you have on the mound that are 100% fresh, with McIntyre, Hagen Smith, and Brady Tigard, who have all are keen to make appearances tonight. You feel really good. But out of the guys that were thrown in there yesterday, and pretty much just, let's face it, probably the only three that you're going to see that you saw yesterday going forward would be Zach Morris, Evan Taylor, and Cole Ramage. Out of those three, which one do you think you would have the most confidence in putting the ball in their hands in a clutch moment on Wednesday when hopefully you're playing Ole Miss again?
Yeah, I would say Evan Taylor, and it's because of Evan Taylor's track record this year. You know, Cole Ramage might have the most College World Series experience, but I really think Evan Taylor's been able to prove that he can come out of the bullpen, he can throw hard, and he can throw pretty consistent. I know that he's had some outings that haven't been great, but if I had to pick out of those three, just from a experienced background that we've seen this year, I'm going with Evan Taylor.
Mm-hmm. That's obviously, I think, I agree with you. That's exactly who I'd go with. And you know, on the offensive side of the ball last night, it obviously wasn't what you expected. I mean, you expected to be able to have a few more bats, especially in the middle of your roster. Facing Auburn today, does this feel like it is gearing up to be a slugfest of it being, you know, a 9-8, you know, 10-9 type of ball game? Because we all know, especially with Sonny D for Auburn, they can hit the ball pretty well too.
Yeah, they can. And if you're Will McIntyre, you're really hoping that's not the case.
Exactly.
You're hoping you get some pitching out of your guys, because if it is a slugfest, man, I just don't know if Arkansas wants to make this a bullpen game. So what you would love to see is, you know, Will McIntyre kind of give you a performance like Connor Nolan did in that first game against Stanford. But offensively, the one guy that needs to kind of get back on track is Caden Wallace. I don't know if maybe – putting a little too much pressure on himself. He had such a great series with Oklahoma State and with North Carolina. Maybe he's pressing a little bit too much. But you got to get Caden Wallace because, look, Jalen Battle's hitting the ball really, like even last night, hit the ball really well. You've got Peyton Stovall, who is so much more comfortable right now than we've seen throughout the season with him. And if you get Caden Wallace going and that top of the lineup going, that's where you're going to find some success. So, yeah, you hope Arkansas can put up 9 runs on the board. You're just hoping that, you know, you don't see that kind of offensive power from Auburn. Maybe Arkansas's defense and their pitching staff can do what Ole Miss was able to do and keep Auburn off the scoreboard.
Well, the weather's changed, and not only is the temperature dropped, but the direction of the wind has changed, too. It's no longer coming out of the south-southeast, so it's no longer, you know, like blowing 25 miles right in the batter's face any longer. And you're going to get a little bit of help going out towards the outfield. I guess that also means fewer beach balls get on the field today, right?
What was the beach ball pitch count? Was it eight? Eight beach balls.
That's a lot for a 9-inning game. That's like a beach ball per inning, man. That's a tough stat to match.
Will was keeping track for it.
And that's one of the things that, you know, stands out about the College World Series is the beach balls. And the other thing are the crowds yesterday. I mean, Arkansas's crowd never really got a chance to get going. Ole Miss was loud when they scored, but really that was about it. And now it's a Tuesday, and a lot of fans already – I wonder, is that are there fewer fans now here? Because I know a lot of folks that, you know, have to work and had to get back to Fayetteville and might not be able to make it here for this game. They might have thought, all right, they win on Monday. I'll just come back when they get to the championship series. I have a feeling there's probably just a bit fewer fans here today.
Yeah, I think so. A lot of people that I talked to were here for Saturday, maybe Monday, but we got to go back. Maybe we come back Saturday if they're here. It's such an easier drive for Arkansas fans than anyone else. Maybe Oklahoma fans have got that kind of proximity where they can go back and forth. I ran into some people from Searcy yesterday who had gotten into town, but were leaving today. So I think you're going to see a lot more people here on the weekend, but this is definitely going to be a thinner crowd of fans. But you also have some Arkansas fans who make trips out of it and you know, rent Airbnbs like we do and stay the whole time, and it's the summer family vacation. So, no, I don't think there's going to be as many as we saw yesterday or Saturday, but there's still some wandering around here.
Hey, Alyssa, I know we have you here on the phone with us, but how's Courtney doing? Because I know she was in Stillwater. She was in Chapel Hill.
Yeah.
She's here. She's like us. You know, she's been all over the place, and the team's played. I think this is 6 weeks in a row on the road. How's Courtney doing?
She's doing well. This is what she signed up for. This is what I told her she was going to get herself into when she joined us back in March. And so she's doing good. I think she's holding up right now. Now, how her cat's doing at home is a completely different story. Biscuit might be a little mad at her when she finally gets home.
I know what that feels like. Kiki's probably – she's mad at me right now, too. That's a fact. That's a fact. And I know because – and I'll give you a little secret here. You can do a drop-in on your Amazon, on your Alexa. I've actually called my cat a couple of times just so that I know she's still alive. It's not like, you know, she. I just want to know she's alive. That's
Bill,
it.
The crazy cat lady. Okay.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
I mean.
Yeah, Courtney's got a nice friend looking after Biscuit. But, yeah, she's going to have to do some sucking up to her cat when she gets home for being gone so long.
We have these great technologies, so we use them when, you know, whichever way helps us. Alyssa, thanks for joining us, and hopefully we're here another day and we can talk about it again. Thanks for your time, as always.
I hope so, guys. Yeah, always. Thanks, guys.
Appreciate it, Alyssa.
It's Alyssa Orange from Pig Trail Nation, who joins us every Tuesday here on Halftime. Halftime's coverage of the College World Series brought to you in part by Kia, Crane Kia of Fayetteville. That's where you find your next gas saver during their MPG days at Crane Kia of Fayetteville. And we'll be here with the Hogs as long as they're in Omaha. You want to go check on the cat for me? Because that's the only other way. I mean, it's either an Alexa call or I get somebody to do a drop-in for me just so I know she's alive.
Well, you know, it's all tongue-in-cheek.
Ty's done it for me once. Have you done that yet?
I have not. But if I decide to go up that way in the next couple days, I'll drop by.
All right, good. Good. I'm going to program the cat to start biting your ankles when you walk in. Wrapping up the first hour next.
A pre-owned vehicle that won't break the bank? Good luck in this market.
But wait, Joe knows good deal. Joe can get you in a pre-owned truck starting at only $299 a month. And all our vehicles are backed by the Crane Commitment, including a 100-year, 100,000-mile warranty. Joe knows how to give you more for your trade and save your hard-earned cash. The best deals are right here in Fort Smith at the Crane Used Car Supercenter, U.S. Highway 71 in Fort Smith.
For more than 80 years, Forsgren Inc. has been building the foundations of the River Valley. Forsgren, a destination point for men and women with a drive towards excellence, is now hiring experienced dump truck drivers. CDL Class A or B license with medical card is required. Apply now from any device, anywhere, anytime at ForsgrenInc.com. Forsgren offers top wages and benefits. Apply today at ForsgrenInc.com. Become part of the Forsgren legacy. Apply now on any device at ForsgrenInc.com. Forsgren Incorporated is an equal opportunity employer.
Champion Cycling, located at 5500 Massard Road, is a locally owned bike shop in Fort Smith that wants to help you find the joy in cycling that has been a part of their family for years. Their goal is to find the right bike for you, whether it's a road bike, mountain bike, or just a bike for leisure. Champion Cycling is totally stocked and has a large selection of bikes, including brands from Specialized, Pivot, and Look. Whether it's fixing a flat tire or a basic tune-up, their dependable service department is always ready to help. Stop by Champion Cycling today at 5500 Massard Road, and they will help you find your joy in cycling.
Riley Farm Dental, at the entrance to Riley Farms, provides every type of dental care and procedures for you and your family. From general dentistry, braces, implants, and cosmetics, Dr. Bo Sparkman and Dr. Brogan give all of their patients better lives with a better smile, more confidence, and a comfortable experience every time. Riley Farm Dental, 5901 Riley Park Drive, Suite A, at the entrance to Riley Farms. Call 226-3500 for an appointment or visit RileyFarmDental.com.
Carco Auto Sales takes great pride in serving Fort Smith, the River Valley, and Eastern Oklahoma for over 40 years, offering a variety of quality, late model, low mileage vehicles at unbeatable values. The friendly and knowledgeable staff can help you find the car you deserve, priced to fit your budget. Carco Auto Sales will purchase your vehicle as well. Come see the team at 2810 Midland Boulevard or give them a call at 783-1722. Check them out online at buyfromcarco.com. Carco Auto Sales, when you're ready.
How would you like for your family to swim for free for a year? Well, it's possible this summer with Burton Pools and Spas. It's the Red, White, and Blue Savings event going on now. Hi, Tommy Kraft here for Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale and in Fort Smith. Here's the deal. Choose 0% interest and no payments for the next 12 months, or take a rebate up to $2,000 off on Doughboy semi-in-ground pools or Doughboy above-ground pools. It's the Red, White, and Blue Savings event going on right now, and there's no better way to spend time with your family this summer than in your own backyard with your own pool by Doughboy. Nobody makes a better semi-in-ground pool or above-ground pool than Doughboy. And you can always trust the team from Burton Pools and Spas for a quality installation. Hey, this is a limited-time offer at Burton Pools and Spas in Springdale and in Fort Smith. Swim for free for a year. Find out more online at burtonpools.com. 0% offer good with approved credit at Burton Pools and Spas, Springdale, and in Fort Smith, where you can get your feet wet without getting in over your head.
Hi, I'm Kelly Smith, owner of Dixie Digital Imaging. Would printing from your phone or tablet make your life easier? Are you emailing files to yourself so that you can print them from your desktop or laptop? The Xerox VersaLink and AltaLink lines of network printers and multifunction printers will natively print using your phone's built-in capabilities. Apple AirPrint and Google Cloud Printing just work. To order yours today, give us a call at 783-6600 or visit dixiedigital.com. Dixie Digital Imaging, bringing document innovations to the River Valley.
Your home for every Razorback football, basketball, and baseball game. ESPN 95.3. Hey, the Hogs are back in the College World Series, and ESPN Arkansas and HitThatLine.com are in Omaha. Our daily live coverage of the Hogs in the College World Series is presented by Crane Kia of Fayetteville. Find your next gas saver during our MPG days at Crane Kia of Fayetteville. When it's hot outside and your AC isn't cooling, avoid the hassle. Go Pascal. Schedule your service call today at GoPascal.com. Baptist Health. Amazing has a new home. Find a doctor near you at BaptistHealth.com.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure to follow Halftime on Twitter at Hit That Line AR and on Facebook and Instagram at Hit That Line. Follow the guys on Twitter at Phil Elson PXP, at Matt Travis, and at DBarrett36. Now, back to the guys. Here's Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett.
Halftime brought to you by Norris Material and Supply Flooring Center. They were formerly Fort Smith Flooring, now Norris Material and Supply Flooring Center. They've got vinyl plank flooring in stock right now, starting at 89 cents per square foot, and all kinds of other flooring as well. Laminate, tile vinyl plank, ceramic, waterproof flooring, everything. And the supplies to do it yourself and get professional installation. They even do countertops with huge quantities available at Norris Material and Supply Flooring Center. You can take it all home today. Go online to flooring.norrismS.com or check them out on Facebook. That's Norris Material and Supply Flooring Center. They're at the corner of Wheeler and Y, 803 South Y Street. 479-289-7111 for Norris Material and Supply Flooring Center. We'll go to the phones right now. We got Eddie in Clarksville on hold. Hey, Eddie. I know you're feeling still positive today. The sun has risen, and the Razorbacks will play baseball today. So which Eagles song are you choosing for your theme this afternoon?
Well, you know, gentlemen, I tell you this. I'm going to hold off on that for the moment. You know, I've been part of some disappointing losses in our programs, all our programs, our football, our basketball, not baseball. But last night, what was disappointing to me, and my thing's been for the last couple of weeks, you know, take it to the limit by the Eagles. And suddenly last night, that didn't take place. And what I mean by that, I don't think we came to play our players play to their potential. And tonight, that's got to take place. You know, there's another saying, gentlemen, it says you live to play another day. And that day is going to come tonight. And there's two roads this team can take. Somebody once said, gentlemen, I texted you earlier today, how true this is, even in your own personal lives. Defeat can either define you two ways. It can defeat your will to win, or you can be eager tonight, starting at 6 o'clock against the Auburn Tigers. You can come out with your will to play and win this ball game, to achieve something great, your will to win.
Eddie, I'm going to step in here for a moment because I hear Coach Van Horn say a lot about when it comes into the postseason, sometimes it's a matter of, you know, who wants to be there. And I felt yesterday watching Stanford lose to Auburn, I saw their will disappear right in front of my eyes in the fifth, sixth inning. You could tell by the body language. I don't see that from Arkansas right now. Now, if they're losing, you know, 12 to 4 in the seventh, eighth inning today, maybe you'll see some of that. I don't know. I didn't see that yesterday. And really, the thing, if you want to talk about, like, you know, guys not necessarily living up to their potential yesterday, it was more on the pitching side than the hitting side. I think Hunter Elliott, who pitched for Ole Miss, threw a really good game. He probably shouldn't have given up a single run, even though he's charged with three. Only one of them earned, and I don't think any of them should have scored. But five runs for Arkansas usually, you know, should be enough for a win. It's been enough for a win in each of the last four games. It's the pitching that didn't pitch to its potential. Zach Moore, I don't think Zach Morris is really like a starting pitcher, and that's not to criticize the choice to go with him. He's what you got to work with right now, and the numbers did show Ole Miss does not have better numbers against lefties than righties. And the plan was to string it out with lefties yesterday, but that plan got blown up in the first inning and certainly in the second inning because Evan Taylor wasn't able to pitch to his talent level either yesterday. But, I mean, he also gives up a two-run homer to one of the best hitters in the country in Tim Elko. He could have hit a home run off anybody.
A darn tennis player being able to get his wrists around that. I mean, how else do you describe it of a guy taking a pitch that far outside, getting his hands all the way around it, and pulling the ball to left center? I mean, that was just – was phenomenal. It looked like a tennis player out there.
Yeah, I didn't see Arkansas's will break yesterday. I saw Stanford's will break. And when you have a sense that your season is coming to an end, you can see that in players' eyes. You can see that in their countenance. and in just the way that they might walk to their position out of the dugout. But the season's not over, and they knew that yesterday. They knew that yesterday. And with their so-called backs up against the wall, I expect to see a pretty well-pitched game, very well played, and hopefully the batters can take advantage of opportunities to score. That's what it's going to take. If Arkansas makes it through this bracket, through the elimination rounds, then it's going to be because of their lineup. It's going to be because they just flat outscored the opponent. There's probably a slugfest in there sooner or later. Last night could have been that. It wasn't. Maybe the bats can answer the bell when it comes to one of those again. Into the second hour of halftime, our number's 877-377-6963. We will be right back.
Michelob Ultra Organic Seltzer opens like every other seltzer. Pours like every other seltzer. But it's not like every other seltzer. USDA certified organic, no added sugar, and low-cal. So you've never seen another seltzer quite like it. And with new refreshing flavors like black cherry and watermelon strawberry, you've never tasted one like it either. Michelob Ultra Organic Seltzer. As real as it tastes. Enjoy responsibly. Not a low-calorie food. Anheuser-Busch Michelob Ultra Organic Seltzer. IRC Beer. St. Louis, Missouri.
Elite Roofing is a locally owned roofing contractor. If you're building a new home or maybe need a new roof on your existing home, Elite Roofing can take care of you. Elite Roofing is known for their dependability and reliability. Just ask any of their satisfied customers. They are licensed and insured, and references are available upon request. If you need a roof, call your local roofing contractors. Elite Roofing, 478-8668. That's 478-8668. Elite Roofing, 478-8668.
The summer sell-down sales event is going on right now at Breen RV in Van Buren. New 2023 models are starting to arrive from Forest River, Keystone, Coachman, and Starcraft, all backed by Breen RV's Free Maintenance for Life program. Cure your summertime blues in a 29-foot Starcraft that sleeps up to 10 people for just $229 a month with zero down. With savings up to $20,000 off MSRP on new travel trailers, now is the best time to get your new RV from Breen RV. That's Breen RV in Van Buren, where adventures begin.
Why do people do business with First Western? Because First Western builds relationships with all of their customers. They partner for the long haul to help you with your financial goals over all seasons of life. First Western is prompt, responsive, and they deliver with quick answers and on-time loan closings. When is the last time your banker called you? If you are looking for a high level of service and a financial partner who will listen and respond, try First Western. For more information, visit them online at firstwestern.com. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Finding an assisted living or senior care facility is one of the most important decisions you'll ever make. Choose the best. Hope's Creek in Van Buren. At Hope's Creek, your loved one will be in apartment-style living, eating three home-style meals daily, and receive the care and services they need. The round-the-clock nursing staff monitors health needs in a secure, monitored environment. Plus, you can check on your loved one anytime with 24-hour access. Stop by for a visit at 2502 Fayetteville Road or check out Hope's Creek online at hopescreek.com.
ESPN Arkansas weather.
For today, what you see is what you're going to get. Plentiful sunshine and hot temperatures are high right around 95 today. Mainly clear, we settle back into the low 70s tonight. Sunny, just as hot tomorrow, highs near 95, and we head into the mid-90s again for Thursday and Friday. I'm Sally Russell with your forecast on ESPN Arkansas.
ESPN 95.3 and hitthatline.com.
I hate everything you just said.
KERX Parasport Smith. This is Halftime, coming at you from the Busch Light Studios on ESPN 95.3.
They're hilarious.
Live from the Busch Light Studios.
I love Arkansas. I love everything here. Give me that thing here.
Your favorite Arkansas sports talk station.
And this one belongs to the Razorbacks.
Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
Fans are amazing. It is lit down here on the sideline.
This is Halftime with Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett.
My calculations are correct. When this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're going to see some serious...
Here come the students. Oh, here come the students. They're coming from the south end, and this one has been a long time brewing.
I have been waiting for this moment for a long time.
Judging by the sound of it, so has everyone else.
Hey, hold on. It's almost halftime.
Welcome into the second hour of halftime here. Phil Elson in DJ's Dugout in downtown Omaha. The place is beginning to thin out a little bit because it's about an hour before Texas A&M and Notre Dame play. I got some Notre Dame. I think these are Notre Dame students. Are you guys students still? There's five fans behind me. They're all a little younger than our resident Reverend Paul Andrew Barrett here.
But they look Notre like Dame, children compared to me.
They're Notre Dame fans, and I just let they have no idea how much Arkansans hate the Texas Longhorns and the Texas A&M Aggies. Well, now they have a clue. Now they know. So they realize that we're all rooting for them, and they're God bless you guys, really, because you're the only Notre Dame fans in this sea of weird maroon here at DJ's Dugout. So
did that one kid get in a fist fight with another fan? He's got gauze in his nose.
My partners are wondering if maybe you got in a fist fight. He's got a nosebleed going on here at the table, which is incredibly appetizing. But, hey, you know, stuff happens sometimes. 877-377-6963 to get with us today.
It's marinara.
For those who weren't with us during the first hour, I don't care about the Jell-O shot thing anymore. And that apparently might have ticked off one of our usual texters. Does anybody care about the Jell-O shot thing anymore?
No.
Or do we
got bigger stuff to worry
pockets?
About. We got bigger fishes to fry right
yeah,
now.
Yeah.
Okay?
Do we realize we're lining the pockets of corporate owners of corporate America that are making probably $4.40 per Jell-O shot? I don't care anymore about the thing. We get people spending $4,500 on powder. And not even on just pre-made Jell-O shots. I stopped caring about it yesterday, and I want to know if you care about it anymore. 877-377-6963.
I personally don't care about it, and most people that I know don't care about it.
What are better things you could spend your money on than prepackaged Jell-O shots?
I mean, Billy here in
like
Fort
a hotel
Smith
room
texted me. He said, once I saw someone buy hundreds at a time, I was out. Businesses buying thousands worth. Just so stupid now. And somebody, I feel like that's how people feel. Once you take out the 1v1 type of thing, a fan walks in and goes, oh, I'll add to the total for my alma mater. Give me two for Arkansas. And then the guy for the rest of the bar goes, hey, you'd get ahead of my team. Two for Stanford, please. Once you get out of that, like the actual, like, the buddiness, like, competitiveness of it. And that's what this thing has always been. That's why last year when Mississippi State had 2,890 something, it was like, what the heck? Because most times the fan base that wins is like right at about like 700-800. Now that it's become this almost, you know, measuring contest of, you know what I mean, it's lost all of its good taste into it.
How about like a contest for raising money for charity?
That would be great.
Maybe for Arkansas fan base like that instead of who spent the most money on a weird drink.
Is there some way to raise money for charity and also get drunk? Because I think wanting to get drunk is a big part of all
of
this.
Yes. Have you never done a pub crawl? Most of them are with charities.
With some sort of charity?
I mean, this would be an easy thing to, you know, get with the
right now it's just the Rocco charity.
The food banks of Omaha. We work with different food banks of Fayetteville, of Norman, of these places where these universities are, the Mississippi Food Bank. And, you know, have that be your promotion. The Roccos will take half of their proceeds.
They'd still make a hell of a lot of money.
They still will. I mean, they're still making $3.80 per Jell-O shot, and they're charging $4.50. So that tells you exactly what type of margins they're making. That would be so much better to say, hey, y'all come buy these Jell-O shots, and to the winning team, we'll give 50% of the proceeds.
Great
to
idea.
Second place, we'll give 20. To third place, we'll give 10. That way, there's multiple winners, and that way, we're helping out communities.
Right.
And we're not just having a measuring contest here. And I'm not for that.
There's an ice cream shop like 6 or 7 blocks from here in the old market, and they've got a little contest of which fan base tips their staff the most.
Mm-hmm.
Like I could get with that one a little bit.
I'm with
bit
that
more.
Too. Tip that, your waitresses.
That ice cream shop also has a very I found this a little bit weird. They've got an old-school soda machine in it, you know, with the old big buttons on it that you used to punch, and it would fall out there.
And then your drink is nice and shaken up for you.
Right. So, I mean, and you can tell it's old, too, because the sodas cost 50 cents. But there are two notes that are taped to the soda machine. One says all profits go to orphans, women, and and you know, some other group of people in Burundi and Sierra Leone. It's a lovely, lovely thought that they're raising money for disadvantaged people in two countries. The other thing that is taped onto this soda machine says out of order. I mean, like, so what are we doing here?
I don't know.
It had a weird feeling to it. We're going to do a really nice thing once this thing gets fixed. Never. Anyway.
And to people that might be texted in, you know, with your thumbs going on, we're not sitting here being, you know, anti-capitalist or anti-small business or anti-anything here. We just feel like it'd be in such better taste to, you know, take the profits and, you know, maybe Rocco's does something like that.
We're the ones that have to suggest this to him. Rocco, you didn't think of this yourself.
Maybe Rocco does. Maybe the wait staff, they get all in on the fun, and at the beginning of the week they split up into eight teams, and whatever university wins, well, that server or bartender on that team, they might get a week off, or maybe they get a bonus. We don't know what they might do. They might be doing some extra stuff behind the scenes.
They might
but
be.
But I would
they
like.
Might
I would
be
just
doing
like
that.
To. I would just like to think that there's more than just gimme.
They could be doing that. They could also be using all this money to buy illegal weapons and stockpiling. I don't know what they're going to do.
Could be running the cartel.
They could. You know.
I mean,
wow. They could. Yeah.
I mean, we
some really nefarious activities.
There are. And once again, so we're not being sued for anything here. We have no evidence of this.
No.
These are just hypothetical situations. We are not
in a world where anything's possible.
We are not accusing or denying that Rocco's Pizza does or doesn't do these things. So I just want to get that out there on the record. So whatever lawyers Rocco might have, don't come after us.
Right,
but we don't know. They could be doing good things with this.
And
they could be doing bad stuff.
Their pizza may be the best pizza you've ever had in your entire life.
Never
it could been. Also be the absolute worst pizza you've ever had, and you should stay really far away from them. I don't know. I've never been there.
Do we know? No, we don't.
Here's a guarantee that this is not an anti-capitalist show. Yet we're incredibly anti-capitalist until we start playing those darn commercials.
Exactly. You got to pay the bills.
Got to pay the bills, don't we?
Let's go to the phones. Yeah, Jason Bateman is the accountant for Rocco's. That's funny. That's a good one. Tuna's on hold. What's up, Charlie? How are you?
I'm great, guys. I can guarantee you this. You three guys are awesome. How about that?
Thank you. I think we can agree on that.
Yeah, I mean, there's no, like, alternative. Like, there's no alternative to that. I don't care what you guys say. No other theory. Drew is just awesome. Phil and Bubba, even though Drew's jealous about that.
I'll get over it.
Yeah, I mean, Maddie's just awesome. That's what I know. Okay. But anyway, Phil, yesterday I was so excited going into that one. Obviously, what happened last night, I know a lot of people, we want to blame it. We didn't pitch well, obviously, but I'm going to give Ole Miss a lot of credit. They were just better last night. And in every way. And one thing we talk about with this team, the strength of this team is, if we can get ground balls. And we didn't get many of them. And the ones that we did, they were hit very hard through the infield. So I'm going to give Ole Miss credit. We just did not pitch well. Nobody other than, I think, I'm drawing a blank here. The guy that went in later with the little mustache and the long hair.
Elijah Trest.
He was the only guy I felt like that just decently did a decent job there for a couple innings of just locating pitches. And I know he walked a couple guys, but that was towards, the end of his release there. And I thought he was the only guy. And Wiggins had one good inning. And, they were talking on the broadcast, Phil, about Wiggins and just how God-given talented he is. He's unbelievably talented. I think everybody knows that. And he will be pitching at the next level. But they were talking – and I don't know if you probably agree with him, but they were talking about a mechanical issue with him. It doesn't seem when he throws that it's kind of like he's all over the place. Like, I don't know. They were talking about trying to, and he's 6'6", and they were talking about the height, being an issue sometimes for taller pitchers. It takes a little longer to get that consistent throwing motion down. With him, they were talking about how the velocity would always be there, but when he misses so badly. And they were talking about, maybe mechanically the pitching staff working with him and maybe working on some of that, those issues. Because, I mean, God, you can just see the talent. It's like when he came in and he started throwing, I'm like, this kid is so talented. He's got it, the talent. but there is some definitely some mechanical issues that are there.
It's a matter of fine-tuning some things, Charlie, and it's like I said. I mean, there've been a lot of pitchers that have had success in the major leagues that really couldn't put it together in college. It's just they're young, and there's still a lot of coaching.
He's so young.
Yeah, and it isn't – honestly, it's not an indictment of the Arkansas coaching staff either if a pitcher like Jackson Wiggins doesn't figure it out at Arkansas.
No, it
is. It's proof that pitching is incredibly hard to do.
Definitely.
Yeah, I mean, the talent's there. There's scouts that are here to see somebody throw triple digits. Jackson Wiggins is a first-round arm, you know, and that's probably even if he doesn't have a successful career at Arkansas or wherever if he doesn't stay here after this. It's just a tough thing to figure out, man.
Yeah, it is. And they are – it's hard. I think they're looking at – you know, I think – you know, scouts probably do kind of like they do in the NBA and baseball. They're looking out. They're looking out in the future, you know, 3 to 5 years probably on him, you know, what he could be. You're projecting, you know,
this guy. That's exactly right. You're projecting.
And the same with Hagen Smith and, Tiger, those two guys, I think, you know, we could – you know, I think they'll wind up being a little better at Arkansas just overall. But those two guys as well. Just anybody that we put out there last night, man, they just didn't have it other than, I think, Trask. He had a couple good innings there. And, you know, that's the reason we lost because, you know, we didn't play Connor. Hey, you know, they were hitting the ball, but it was soft contact in the infield. And we can throw people out when we get those.
Charlie, what happened last night? Is you ran into a team.
I appreciate it, guys. I'll hang up with.
Hey, good to hear from you, Charlie. You ran into a team that's got their starting pitching figured out. Their bullpen is rock solid right now, and because of how good the pitching is for Ole Miss, and that was the big you know, variable all year. Now that lineup can take hold and have a sense that, look, I mean, they scored 13 runs yesterday. They win games scoring 4 or 5 runs right now. It's just a team that's really well put together by Mike Bianco. They're veteran, and they're emerging at the right time, just like Oklahoma is too. And Arkansas has emerged as well. And just with the loss last night doesn't mean they can't win 3 games in a row. We'll just see how it happens. And, by the way, Andy Burcham has just sat down across from me. He's the voice of Auburn Athletics. So stay tuned. We'll do some preview of Arkansas and Auburn after this as halftime continues.
This is Toyota Tuesday on the Morning Rush. Get by your local Toyota dealer for a test drive today. Toyota, let's go places. The Hogs are back in the College World Series, and ESPN Arkansas and HitThatLine.com are in Omaha. Our daily live coverage of the Hogs in the College World Series is presented by Crane Kia of Fayetteville. Find your next gas station.
The company you can trust when it comes to building quality fencing and gates is looking for quality people to join the Fence Man team. If you are a fence builder or have building or welding experience, apply in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man offers great pay and a $500 sign-on bonus. Join the top fence building team and get a $500 sign-on bonus. The Fence Man. Apply today in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man is an equal opportunity employer.
Now that's a dandy white perch. Big old slab.
C'est bon, succulent.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappies.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland, America's favorite. White perch, slab, succulent, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
This song was mistakenly thought to be about animal rights or shock therapy, but Shock the Monkey is really about jealousy. If we're just highly evolved primates, then why does adultery make us so irate? Natural selection would never make you hate someone who would seminate. It's because a supernatural God wired monogamy into our DNA. If you think this issue is benign, you'll be shocked to see Proverbs 6:29. I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Read about it.
DentSource, the leader in auto hail repair for over 20 years. Our certified technicians service all vehicles and offer a lifetime warranty. DentSource will keep you on the road with a courtesy vehicle and offer free pickup and delivery. DentSource, now open in Fort Smith.
The Fence Man, the company you can trust when it comes to building quality fencing and gates, is looking for quality people to join the Fence Man team. If you are a fence builder or have building or welding experience, apply in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man offers great pay and a $500 sign-on bonus. Join the top fence building team and get a $500 sign-on bonus. The Fence Man. Apply today in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man is an equal opportunity employer.
Now that's a dandy white perch. Big old slab.
C'est bon, succulent.
One beautiful crappie.
It's a paper mouth.
Some serious crappie.
Nice speck.
We got crappie.
They might go by different names, but all prefer the same thing. Bobby Garland, America's favorite. White perch, slab, succulent, paper mouth, crappie, speck, crappie baits.
I call it dinner.
This song was mistakenly thought to be about animal rights or shock therapy, but Shock the Monkey is really about jealousy. If we're just highly evolved primates, then why does adultery make us so irate? Natural selection would never make you hate someone who would seminate. It's because a supernatural God wired monogamy into our DNA. If you think this issue is benign, you'll be shocked to see Proverbs 6:29. I'm Pastor Heath from Woodland. Read about it.
Dent Source, the leader in auto hail repair for over 20 years. Our certified technicians service all vehicles and offer a lifetime warranty. Dent Source will keep you on the road with a courtesy vehicle and offer free pickup and delivery. Dent Source, now open in Fort Smith.
The Fence Man, the company you can trust when it comes to building quality fencing and gates, is looking for quality people to join the Fence Man team. If you are a fence builder or have building or welding experience, apply in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man offers great pay.
ESPN
95.3.
Hey, sorry! The Hogs are back in the College World Series, and ESPN Arkansas and HitThatLine.com are in Omaha. Our daily live coverage of the Hogs in the College World Series is presented by Crane Kia of Fayetteville. Find your next gas saver during our MPG days at Crane Kia of Fayetteville. When it's hot outside and your AC isn't cooling, avoid the hassle. Go Pascal. Schedule your service call today at GoPascal.com. Baptist Health. Amazing has a new home. Find a doctor near you at BaptistHealth.com.
Southbound, cruising with a half pound, blue light spinning round, better put the hammer down, good old Tennessee, ain't nobody stopping the short run, state line, gotta keep making time, Alabama high tech.
Now, back to the guys, here's Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett.
Always good to catch up with Andy Burcham, the voice of Auburn Tigers Athletics. We usually do over to the phone when we're on the show, but he's sitting right across from me here at DJ's Dugout, sipping on a soda. How you doing, Andy?
I'm doing well, Bill. How are you today,
I'm great. Bud? Yeah, you made the trip from all the way across the street from the team hotel.
I started early, got here early, so here we go.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's going to be a good one today, man. I mean, any game in the College World Series, you expect to be a good game, but I think every game is going to be good, and then we get nothing but blowouts so far. It's just been a big surprise as far as that's concerned.
It has. Auburn's two games have not been of the blowout variety yet. Auburn's pitched it pretty well. Even the loss against Ole Miss, struck out 13 against the Rebels, held them to 5 in that first game. The problem for Auburn in the first game is it did not hit the ball very well.
Mm-hmm.
And Auburn's run up against two really, really good starters in these last two series. The middle game at Oregon State, the Jerpy kid is as electric as anybody I've seen in a long, long time. Left-hander with movement on every pitch. And then DeLucia on Saturday just shut Auburn down. Auburn got to him just a little bit, but Ole Miss is on a bit of a roll right now.
They really seem like it, don't they?
And you can say the same thing about Oklahoma on the other side.
Yeah, I mean the teams that are 2-0, they're sitting pretty.
Right,
they're sitting pretty, and in a much different way than in a weekend regional. You know, where you still don't get a day off.
Right.
I mean, the day off
huge
is the thing when it comes to being here in Omaha.
Yeah, and Auburn losing that first game for Auburn to make it to the championship game, they had to win yesterday. They've got to win tonight. And then they got to win two more games against Ole Miss to get there. And there is no day off until you get to the championship series. So it is so imperative to win that first game in this tournament. Auburn's not done that since 1967. And Auburn hadn't won a game in the tournament since 97.
Wow.
When Auburn's current pitching coach, Tim Hudson, beat Rice, was the winning pitcher, hit a two-run homer, and drove in six in that game.
That's amazing. He actually was hitting then, too.
Yes. Oh, he was the SEC Player of the Year his senior year. Hit 20 bombs his senior year.
Yeah. You know, we see it's amazing, these guys. Does he ever throw batting practice?
Not much.
When we were in Oklahoma State, Andy, Matt Holliday is throwing batting practice to his. He looks like he could go out and hit right now. He still has the Popeye forearms. It blew me away. I'm like, he looks bigger than he did when he was playing for the Cardinals.
Yeah. It's interesting. You see, we're seeing more major league guys, and not just major league guys, big name major league guys. Tim Hudson's on the Auburn staff. Troy Tulowitzki.
There's talk he might be a head coach somewhere soon.
Well, I was talking to a former USC player who was here. We were walking to the stadium together, and that player was talking about Tulowitzki for their vacant job there. So, yeah, his name's being out there. Matt Holliday at Oklahoma State. You're seeing more and more. I mean, I know it for a long time we saw Tom Pagnozzi there.
Yep.
And I'm a Cardinals guy. I grew up near St. Louis, so I follow the Cardinals. So it was interesting. We were out the last time we were in Fayetteville for baseball, we went to Herman's.
Which is
we always go there. And Pagnozzi was back in the corner.
Yep.
So it was interesting to see him. But there seems to be more of those big-name, big-league guys that are trying to get into the college game right now.
All right, so everybody wants to talk about Sonny DeShera when it comes to Auburn, and rightfully so. Yeah. I mean, watching the guy hit is really something else. But you win yesterday without him really doing much. I mean, he struck out at three at-bats, even got called for a batter's interference, if I remember correctly.
That was Pierce.
Oh, that was Pierce.
That was the guy behind him, yeah.
Okay, but, you know, so what are some of the other batters that you got to watch out for when it comes to the Auburn Tigers? Because it seems DeShera and Pierce are kind of like the main guys. Who else has hit well in the postseason?
When I did the pregame show with Butch Thompson yesterday, I said, who's your offensive key? This was going into to yesterday's game against Stanford. And he said very quickly, it's Blake Rambush, who's at the leadoff guy for Auburn. And he was 0-for in the game against Ole Miss, and he did not have a hit in the series, the Super Regional at Oregon State. But Rambush gets two base hits yesterday. He scores both times. And when Rambush has scored two or more runs in a game, Auburn is undefeated this season.
Interesting. Has he always batted leadoff?
He has been Auburn's leadoff guy for probably two-thirds of this season. He was around the lineup, they moved him to the top of the lineup, and he has flourished there for Auburn. Odd to see a guy like him that leads the team in stolen bases, but he's a corner infielder.
That's true.
That's your third baseman.
Yeah.
And Andy, you talk about this is the first win that y'all got yesterday in Omaha since 1997. What's the vibe of the fan base? I mean, just the Auburn fans that are there and just the ones that are back in the state of Alabama. Is it a play with house money feeling right now that it's been a great season regardless of how or when it ends, or is there some pressure on this team to really perform here in Omaha?
You know, when Auburn came here in 2019, I think most fans felt that Auburn was playing with house money that year. But Butch Thompson, going into the regional this year and after Auburn won that regional, he didn't talk like a coach that was just happy to win a regional. And that was Auburn's first regional at home since 2010. And I know you guys at Arkansas are used to hosting
spoiled,
in the postseason.
Spoiled by
okay.
Andy.
All right, okay. But for Auburn, I think Auburn has taken that Auburn is using that this year. This will be a team that's disappointed if it doesn't make the championship series. And it will be tough. We all know how tough it will be because you lost that first game. But it is a different vibe this year than it was in 19. And I think Butch Thompson wants that to become the case with this team. We're not just happy to make a regional. We're not just happy to get to Omaha. We want to win. We need to win in Omaha. And that hasn't necessarily been the case for Auburn in years past. Butch Thompson is trying to do that. He's done it now two of the last three seasons, brought this team to Omaha. A lot of firsts this year, getting to host a regional, winning a regional. They've won two straight super regionals, which had never happened until what they've done the two of the last three seasons now. So it's a different deal at Auburn right mm-hmm. now with Butch Thompson and what he's done with this program.
And that's ultimately a good thing, Andy. I mean, mad and pissed off fans are fans that care. You want fans to constantly want to push your program. You want the expectation. You want that bar to constantly rise. You never want to just be okay with just getting to something. You want to eventually have the program that is there to win it all and has a great shot. Mason Barnett's set to start for Auburn tonight. For an ideal outing for Auburn tonight, how far into the game does Barnett need to be out there? Does he need to go full six? Does he need to go seven, possibly even eight? Like, what's the range for him? Say, if he goes blank, Auburn's probably going to win the ball game.
If he gets through six tonight for Auburn and is effective,
mm-hmm.
Auburn feels very, very good about his start. He's probably been Auburn's best starter in the postseason. He was terrific against UCLA in the regional championship game. He might have gone at the distance had we not had a rain delay and had to pick up the game the next day.
Mm-hmm.
He was as good as he's ever been as a starter at Auburn. And he was good in spite of the fact that Auburn lost that game. He was just going up against maybe the best starter that Auburn has seen this year in Cooper Jerpy for Oregon State. But he was very, very good at Oregon State. So he's been terrific for Auburn. Auburn feels good about this rotation in spite of the fact that it lost its Friday night guy in the Tennessee series this year in Hayden Mullins.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And when that happened, Barnett went from the midweek guy into the rotation. And Auburn was fortunate to have a Mason Barnett to get into the rotation at that point because, as we all know, when you lose one of your weekend guys, all of a sudden you're scrambling a little bit.
And it feels like everybody's lost one of them this year,
sure,
too.
Sure, absolutely. And some have lost more than mm-hmm. that.
That's right.
At this point.
I think what Butch has done at Auburn is amazing, Andy. I mean, you just look at the two SEC programs in baseball out of Alabama, and you're already starting with one foot in the bucket because – you don't have the lottery. There are certain advantages that some schools have based upon the idea that baseball teams are only funded by 11.7 scholarships. Mississippi's got their own recruiting thing going on with basically their own JUCO league. Arkansas gives state level tuition to schools that border the state of Arkansas. And you have students that get help with tuition because of the lottery in Arkansas. Florida's got the same thing. I mean, they're built in.
Hope
advantages.
Scholarship in Georgia.
Yeah. Vanderbilt has, you know, they pay for everybody, basically.
Right.
So, I mean, Auburn and Alabama are starting with a disadvantage, yet this is the second time in three tournaments that you guys are in the College World Series. I think it's incredible.
Well, and let me add one more. You talked about the in-state tuition. You cannot. It's against the law in Alabama. The state legislature will not allow you. It's not an Auburn thing or an Alabama thing. It's a state legislature thing that you can't offer in-state tuition to a student-athlete. Men or women, doesn't matter at this point. So you don't have that. And there are some things that Auburn works against. And listen, it's trying to improve its stadium and add some luxury seating that it doesn't have at this point. That a lot of programs, like we see at Charlie Baum Field, or you see at Duty Noble, or you see at Swayze Field, or, you know, Alec Box Stadium, or wherever you go. So Auburn's trying to get there from a facility standpoint, and Butch Thompson has done this and recruits very well. Carl Nonnemaker, mm-hmm. a former Vanderbilt guy, is Auburn's recruiting coordinator and has done just a wonderful job. And Auburn has helped itself with the transfer portal. You talked about Sonny DeShera. He's a guy that transferred. Auburn's DH, Brooks Carlson, another reliever, Chase Isbell. They all three transferred in from Samford
mm-hmm.
this year and all been main cogs in what Auburn has done this season.
Andy, we'll end it right there, man.
Right.
I appreciate you stopping by again. It's
I'll
good to talk to you. Yeah, I'll see you over at the ballpark in like 5 hours, probably
right.
less than that.
Appreciate
Better
it, Andy.
Start to prep.
My
you
pleasure,
don't
guys.
Much time. It's Andy Burcham, right. the voice of Auburn Athletics here on Halftime. And, hey, if you want to watch the game, of course, if you're not just going to sit there and listen to it and you want to get something to eat, well, the place to be would be Twin Peaks in Rogers. Of course, they've got 29-degree draft beer all night long. And you can celebrate the College World Series and enjoy yourself at Twin Peaks and Rogers. Plus, they've got their fabulous scenic views, great food, and fantastic atmosphere. More TVs, bigger screens, and more to watch at Twin Peaks in Rogers. Call us or text us on halftime at 877-377-6963, and we will be right back.
This is Toyota Tuesday on the Morning Rush. Get by your local Toyota dealer for a test drive today. Toyota, let's go places.
Hardworking simplicity and serious durability. That's the winning combination you get when you pair a rugged Workmaster utility tractor with a Duradisc heavy-duty disc mower, both from New Holland and Williams Tractor, now WT Equipment in Springdale. You'll maximize the tonnage of your hay fields by slicing a clean, close swath up to 10 foot 4 inches wide, all while operating in confidence and comfort with a Workmaster tractor with high visibility all-weather cab. Stop by WT Equipment in Springdale today to learn about this unstoppable New Holland team.
What does amazing sound like? At Baptist Health, we hear it every day. It sounds like countless miracles. Another finish line crossed. One faithful mission.
Amen.
And 100 years of all our best. Thank you for allowing Baptist Health to provide you with compassionate care for the past 100 years. We look forward to serving you for many to come. Visit baptist-health.com to learn more.
Standard Materials Group has immediate openings for ready-mix drivers in the Northwest Arkansas area. If you have a CDL license without an automatic restriction and want to be home every night, want to work with a company that offers great pay, benefits, and a great team environment with growth opportunities, apply today at jobs.crh.com. Again, that's jobs.crh.com. Standard Materials Group is an equal opportunity employer.
This message for listeners in the Knoxville, Augsburg, and surrounding areas. Wave Rural Connect is coming to you. Fast, reliable fiber internet, along with television and phone service from a local provider with the best customer service available. To pre-register, call 833-492-8372 or go online to signup.waveruralconnect.com. Arkansas Valley Electric and Wave Rural Connect, changing the communities we serve.
The Fence Man, the company you can trust when it comes to building quality fencing and gates, is looking for quality people to join the Fence Man team. If you are a fence builder or have building or welding experience, apply in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man offers great pay and a $500 sign-on bonus. Join the top fence building team and get a $500 sign-on bonus. The Fence Man. Apply today in person at 1213 North 32nd Street in Fort Smith. The Fence Man is an equal opportunity employer.
Hey, this is Jason Christie from Park Hill, Oklahoma, the 2022 Bassmaster Classic Champion. I'm excited to tell you about the Booyah Poppin' Pad Crasher Jr. It is a smaller version of the Poppin' Pad Crasher, and it's a bait I'm going to use all summer on the Arkansas River. Frog fishing is one of my favorite things to do when summer fishing, and Poppin' Pad Crasher Jr. is the right size and has the right hook set up to catch them. It's available at LureNet.com and tackle stores everywhere. The Booyah Poppin' Pad Crasher Jr.
Riley Farm Dental at the entrance to Riley Farms provides every type of dental care and procedures for you and your family. From general dentistry, braces, implants, and cosmetics, Dr. Bo Sparkman and Dr. Brogan give all of their patients better lives with a better smile, more confidence, and a comfortable experience every time. Riley Farm Dental, 5901 Riley Park Drive, Suite A at the entrance to Riley Farms. Call 226-3500 for an appointment or visit RileyFarmDental.com.
Law's Drug Store in Fort Smith is open and ready to care for you and your family. Law's Drug Store has COVID vaccinations available for ages 5 and up and the new second booster for ages 50 and up. These vaccines are safe and effective in preventing severe cases of COVID. Call 452-6116 to schedule your booster appointment or stop by Law's Drug Store, 6802 Rogers Avenue behind Outback Steakhouse. Law's Drug Store opens 6 days a week to safely care for you and your family.
Your home for every Razorback football, basketball, and baseball game. ESPN 95.3.
Hey, Surrey!
The Hogs are back in the College World Series, and ESPN Arkansas and HitThatLine.com are in Omaha. Our daily live coverage of the Hogs in the College World Series is presented by Crane Kia of Fayetteville. Find your next gas saver during our MPG days at Crane Kia of Fayetteville. When it's hot outside and your AC isn't cooling, avoid the hassle. Go Pascal. Schedule your service call today at GoPascal.com. Baptist Health. Amazing has a new home. Find a doctor near you at BaptistHealth.com. Find us on 99.5 in Northwest Arkansas, 95.3 in Fort Smith in the River Valley, 96.3 in Hot Springs in Central Arkansas, 104.3 in Harrison and Mountain Home, and everywhere on HitThatLine.com. Now, back to the guys. Here's Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett.
All right, just a little bit of time to wrap things up here on halftime. If you want to be with us, you can either join me at DJ's Dugout, downtown Omaha, over the next 24 minutes or so. I might stick around to polish off a sandwich once it's all said and done. And for those Razorback fans who don't want to be around any Aggies, well, they have mostly headed off to the stadium for Texas A&M versus Notre Dame. Yeah, the kids behind me, these Notre Dame fans, they're going too. They had no clue. They had no clue that the only way to feasibly root for Notre Dame is to either play a team from Texas or to play Tennessee in baseball.
And they've done all three of those things, haven't they?
Yeah, so they're kind of like our heroes. If they could eliminate A&M today, I know.
Throw them in my mouth a little bit.
I know what you just heard.
You don't
like
Notre Dame and hero. Ugh.
You don't like. I'm not asking you to root for the football team.
Okay.
But if they played Alabama, what would you do?
I'd root for Notre Dame.
Right.
I mean, so, when they were playing USC back in the day against the Matt Leiner, Reggie Bush teams, I was definitely team Brady Quinn.
Yeah, it's funny how things have changed, because when I grew up, Notre Dame was not the plucky little underdog that everybody thinks of when it comes to the college football championship. And by the way, they're not the plucky little underdog now. It's just once they get to the Final Four in football, then they are the plucky little underdog. All right, where to go here? Where to go here? Top Gun. You saw Top Gun.
I did see Top Gun.
Maddie's seen Top Gun.
I've seen it.
I finally saw it.
Have all of our listeners seen Top Gun? Because if you have, that's good. If you haven't, are we doing spoilers here?
Sure.
Well,
I mean, realistically, I mean, what is there to spoil? I mean, like, I thought the movie won. I thought the movie was good. I'm just really glad. The thing
okay,
that
here's,
my
here's
movie
a way
experience,
you can you,
experience the best, though. Mm-hmm. Oh, Maddie, it was a pretty packed theater.
Oh, you love it when it's packed.
I love it when it's packed. And you know what? I also love it when the crowd in the theater overreacts to everything.
I think it adds to the experience.
Did you know that Top Gun was a slapstick comedy? It's true. Ask anyone who saw the 135 on Sunday at the Malco here in Fort Smith, and they'll tell you it was laugh out loud. And you know what I also love? I love sitting next to people who think that they're in their living room. I didn't know what was going on. Thank goodness there's this couple in their late 50s, early 60s to constantly explain the plot to each other loud enough for me to overhear and for me to pick up on, you're right, that is a different plane. Wait, there's two in that plane. There's only one in that plane. Now, why is that? They say a team of six, but there's four planes.
Welcome to the sarcastic portion of the show today.
I'm just so glad.
Well, I should hope so, because I'm laying it on pretty thin.
So glad I got to share that cinematic experience with just the chuckleheads of Fort Smith
and
the greatest couple to watch a movie with.
They tell you that it's a community experience sitting in a movie theater with a bunch of people that you don't know. And maybe it is until they start to annoy the ever-loving crap out of you. I love the movie, and you know one of the reasons I might have loved the movie? There were only three other people in the theater.
I'm sure.
That's the way to do it.
See, now here's the main thing. Did any of y'all think the plot or hidden message
oh God, I was
on the same level as like I don't know, a French indie film where you do, I might have to ask somebody, be like, hey, I think I missed that because I can't read subtitles and I obviously don't speak French.
You don't think, like, the plot was so complicated that people needed it explained to them throughout the movie?
Was the plot very complicated?
I compared it to a video game.
It was at the Cannes Film Festival, man. I mean, you can't be at Cannes if you're not going to have some, like, really involved, crazy plot that takes a long time to unwind and have some, you know, real artistic shot. I mean, you show up at a movie like that, you kind of know what you're getting into.
I think Drew's way too easily distracted at the movie theater.
This isn't the
first time that you freaked out, like, with somebody. Was it Ghostbusters Afterlife or something? Or no, it was the James Bond movie, too. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. The James Bond movie was the people before. It was during the previews when they were showing the preview for West Side Story. These two older women.
They ruined the previews for you.
The older women, they just looked at each other. They're about two rows catty quarter in front of me and just go, mm-mm-mm. That's what's wrong with today. No more original ideas. Lady, you're in a James Bond movie. This is the 30th one they've made. And then Spider-Man, I got mad because all the kids, because it was during spring break.
I'm seeing a pattern.
All the kids,
he hasn't had one good
experience. Getting up to go pee. And then in Ghostbusters, as soon as, you know, the guy, the dead Ghostbuster shows up on the screen, everybody's
spoiler
like,
alert.
Ah!
My gosh, spoiler alert. Spoiler alert.
In their mind, like, people, it's okay to just watch a movie.
Did you just age 30 years during this segment?
I'm just saying, man. I don't need your commentary. And I don't know where in Top Gun there were really laughable moments. There were some moments when, that's funny.
Did you?
These people, on the floor, knee slapping.
I figured it out for you. Because you don't need to be around people when you're watching a movie anymore.
I do not.
I can't even imagine what you're like at a theater production, like with on stage, if anybody is talking around you. They shouldn't, but gosh.
I love going
to
the theater.
Stay home. Stay home. Put down the Fandango, pretty please.
But
it's not for you.
But I want to see it on the silver screen just like everybody else. I just want everyone else not to be there.
Save up your money and get a giant television. Get Frank's 2,000-inch TV, okay? Like Weird Al's song said, and then you can sell tickets yourself, and if anybody talks or says anything, you can kick them out of your own theater.
Well, I feel like most people are like thinking that I'm really harsh on people.
Seems
and
like
I probably
it.
Am.
Maybe you
but
are.
But at the same time, if you were sitting next to this couple during Top Gun, where I can hear them over the engines of an F-18 aircraft, you're talking a little loud. Okay?
What
just remember.
Like,
exactly. Howard. What did he say? Is that a different plane?
Oh,
now, I do remember
gosh.
When I went and saw the Batman movie,
mm-hmm.
There was a family next to me, and they decided to bring their, like, 5-year-old little girl, and she had those shoes on that every time they kick their feet, the lights flash. It was... I was a little annoyed. It was every time I'm like, I'm getting kind of lost in the movie, and then I'm completely pulled out of it because there's flashing lights to the left of me from a little girl.
That brings
that.
That makes me just remember. You know what I hate more than other people? Other people's kids.
This is great. Now we've turned this into the Drew hates everything segment. So, and I thought I was in a mood when I got on the air today because of this stupid Jello shot thing. We bring up movie theaters, and all of a sudden, Drew Barrett has turned into the 800-pound gorilla.
And there's the thing. Nobody's forcing me to go see these movies.
It's supposed to be a leisurely activity.
It's supposed to be.
It's supposed to escape the outside world.
This is not very ministerial of you, Drew.
No,
you're supposed to accept people as they are if you're going
to
marry them.
I mean, I'm trying. I try so hard to be an ELE. Everybody loves everybody. And I do outside of movie theaters and when people are just not being dumb, okay? I'll love you, but don't be mad when I call you dumb.
Oh, that might be half the time, which includes us here on this very show.
Good point, Brandon. Too. Someone somewhere is describing Drew as the gripey, complaining dude at the movies.
I don't complain while we're at the movie. I kept my mouth shut. All right.
Well, they're complaining about the guy that kept giving my wife side eye.
Oh, there were some side eye. There was definitely some stare down. Just like, do you mind with my eyes? I didn't say it, but with my eyes, it was you mind?
What do you say we take? What do you say we take a break, Drew?
That's fine.
Maybe a cold shower for the last segment. Stay with us as we wrap things up here on Halftime.
Stay
state sales tax paid on every pre-owned vehicle on the lot now through the end of the month at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. You heard right. State sales tax paid on pre-owned vehicles at Harry Robinson. You'll save hundreds, even thousands, with sales tax paid. This sale does not apply to previously negotiated deals. Don't miss your chance to get your state sales tax paid now through the end of the month on every pre-owned vehicle on the lot. Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off of I-540 at Fort Smith.
Some of my fondest childhood memories are from volunteering with my grandmother. Helping others was her passion. She'd always say, "The sweetest fruits of life come from serving others." And she was right.
At Shelter Insurance, we strive to make a positive impact in the communities where we work and live.
Ask Shelter agents Brandon Zimmerman or Chris Dooley about a free insurance review.
Head to toe, it's gotta be Jelco for hard work and the great outdoors.
With quality and pride, some comfort you like, and savings that you're looking for.
We've got the shoes and boots, steel toes too, outerwear and a whole lot more.
Head to toe, it's gotta be Jelco
for hard work and the great outdoors.
The summer sell-down sales event is going on right now at Breen RV in Van Buren. New 2023 models are starting to arrive from Forest River, Keystone, Coachman, and Starcraft, all backed by Breen RV's Free Maintenance for Life program. Cure your summertime blues in a 29-foot Starcraft that sleeps up to 10 people for just $229 a month with zero down. With savings up to $20,000 off MSRP on new travel trailers, now is the best time to get your new RV from Breen RV. That's Breen RV in Van Buren, where adventures begin.
Is this the right decision? Living with an aging parent can bring stress, uncertainty, and guilt. Ease those emotions and trust that they are safe and happy at Dalton's Place at Waldron. Living in this community improves the health, nutrition, and housing for your loved one, regardless of income. Private apartments allow your mom or dad to keep their independence while their health is always monitored. Contact us today to see if your loved one qualifies. Dalton's Place at Waldron, 520 West 2nd Street. Your well-being first.
Why do people do business with First Western? Because First Western builds relationships with all of their customers. They partner for the long haul to help you with your financial goals over all seasons of life. First Western is prompt, responsive, and they deliver with quick answers and on-time loan closings. When is the last time your banker called you? If you are looking for a high level of service and a financial partner who will listen and respond, try First Western. For more information, visit them online at firstwestern.com. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, this is Melissa with True Grit Running Company. Each day, we see familiar faces who have supported us from the beginning because they see the benefits of an active lifestyle. We're also always meeting new customers who are taking their first steps towards making running or walking a part of daily life. We have the opportunity to share in their successes and help them achieve their goals. The people of Fort Smith and the River Valley are why we believe we were voted one of the best running stores in America. Visit us and see how we can help you. True Grit Running Company, 6808 Rogers Avenue, Suite B, behind Chick-fil-A.
A pre-owned vehicle that won't break the bank? Good luck in this market.
But wait, Joe knows good deals. Joe can get you in a pre-owned truck starting at only $299 a month. And all our vehicles are backed by the Crane Commitment, including a 100-year, 100,000-mile warranty. Joe knows how to give you more for your trade and save your hard-earned cash. The best deals are right here in Fort Smith at the Crane Used Car Supercenters, U.S. Highway 71 in Fort Smith.
Your home for every Razorback football, basketball, and baseball game. ESPN 95.3. Hey, hey, the Hogs are back in the College World Series, and ESPN Arkansas and HitThatLine.com are in Omaha. Our daily live coverage of the Hogs in the College World Series is presented by Crane Kia of Fayetteville. Find your next gas saver during our MPG days at Crane Kia of Fayetteville. When it's hot outside and your AC isn't cooling, avoid the hassle. Go Pascal. Schedule your service call today at GoPascal.com. Baptist Health. Amazing has a new home. Find a doctor near you at BaptistHealth.com.
Set out to get you with a fine-tooth comb. I was soft inside. There was something going on.
Now, back to the guys. Here's Phil Elson, Matty T, and Drew Barrett.
All right, wrapping things up here on halftime, and we'll have a 5:30 airtime for the Razorback Dugout Show on the Baseball Network. 6:07 will be first pitch, Arkansas versus Auburn. The starting pitchers are confirmed. Mason Barnett for Tigers and Will McIntyre for the Razorbacks. I don't know if that's been confirmed yet, but there's really no other choice.
It has been confirmed. I think I saw.
I thought maybe that would be the case by now.
Diamond Hog podcast host Mason Choate has sent out a tweet saying it was. And I also think Hutch tweeted it out too. And don't forget that after the game, we will have Arkansas Hog reaction on all of these stations.
You sound positively thrilled about it.
As soon as the action is, Maddie, there's nothing more that I mean, I love talking baseball, and
No matter how late it is.
I'm going to enjoy it tonight when I leave here at 11:15 again and then get here at 5 a.m.
None of these games is really going to be like sub 3 hours.
Can you ask him to speed it up a little tonight?
I'll do everything I can about
just,
that.
Just lean out of the booth and go, hey, batter! Back in the box. You're wasting too much time. Ticky-tock. Let's go.
It's the commercial break sometimes. And, 10 walks and a couple of hit batters. Mix that in.
That
six
happens.
Pitching changes will certainly extend a baseball game. And seeing 18 runs one game and 19 runs the other is also going to extend a ball game a little bit. I don't know what to expect out of today. Everybody wants to, what do you think? Who's going to win this game and all that? This is the toughest sport to predict. I don't know.
Somebody actually asked, should I feel confident about today?
I think you can feel confident that you're getting a good effort. And, yes, I mean, there is as good of a chance to win this game as any other. And hindsight would be totally 20-20 on looking back into yesterday's ball game. But maybe the deck was stacked a little bit against Arkansas, but just based on the starting pitching matchup. And maybe that would have been the case no matter what, just through the way Ole Miss is playing. But, I think you can feel pretty confident about this today. Arkansas has won 2 out of 3 versus Auburn already this year. They're a better team in the field than Auburn is. And I think they should be able to have an opportunity to score some runs. But, I mean, you want to look like a moron. You want to look really stupid. Go ahead and try to predict a college baseball game.
Ain't that the truth.
You're very rarely going to be right about it.
The only person that's gotten it right and the score right has been Miss Lisa. She did it one time earlier, I think, in the Supers or the regional. She actually was able to predict the game right. So unless your name's Miss Lisa,
I also saw a comment from Miss Lisa about that she knew that Arkansas was going to lose yesterday's game based on who the starting pitcher was.
Come on.
Everybody gets to be a manager. Everybody gets to be a hitting coach and say the guys are doing this or doing that. They just got beat yesterday. They got beat by a team that played better than them, that pitched better than them, that hit better than them. And in baseball, that happens. It's their 19th loss out of 64 games and their second loss in 8 in the NCAA tournament. And crap happens in this weird sport, which could be the case today. Maybe Arkansas wins 17-2 like they did on Saturday. Maybe they lose a 3-0 ball game. You never know what's going to happen in this wild sport. Tell you one thing, though. You should watch it at Joe's Grill and Cantina in Fort Smith because there's two things going on today. For one, it's Taco Tuesday.
It's Taco Tuesday!
Right. I mean, that's an all-day long thing. Dollar tacos all day long, $2.95 for the pork carnita tacos, $3.95 for the brisket or pork belly tacos, and 75 cents for your sides. But during the game, half price apps and taps. How about that? I mean, it's so special. It's special to the nth degree. And that's at Joe's Grilling Cantina in Fort Smith. Download the waiter app to order or go to joesfortsmith.com to do the same. They are right across from Harps in Fort Smith, Joe's Grill and Cantina. All right. Brandon's not scared. He's predicting a 9-3 Arkansas win.
I like your confidence, Brandon.
That's great. Andy in Bentonville, like your anti-human being in the movie theater rant.
Not anti-human being. I'm just anti-dumb people in
movie
theaters.
You don't like dogs? You don't like people?
I never said I don't like dogs. I'm just not the biggest dog person.
You just don't pet them.
Do we have to keep bringing this up, Maddie? It's been a year.
It's been literally a year since yesterday.
And you've still never met my dog.
I've commented on how cute
photogenic
your dog.
She is.
Your dog is the most photogenic dog I've ever seen. I've never actually seen a dog smile for the camera, but your dog 10 out of 10. I mean, knocks it out
of
the
park. She's very talented.
A lot better than my fiance's dog. She doesn't know which way to look.
John,
sometimes she likes to look twice, two different places.
Drew, John just texted in here, and he's automatically just he just can't get with you. He says he automatically beware of people that are not dog people.
I like dogs can sense that.
I like dogs. My fiance's dogs likes me, okay? You're just not going to find me
you know
to
what
walk
that is?
Into her house
that's like
and
the person
be dropped
who says,
to the ground and just go, oh, my God.
A normal
here.
Person, a normal says, person melts like butter.
That's the person that says, I can't stand kids. Mm-hmm. But I like yours. They're okay. And there's a lot of them out there. Charlie thinks Arkansas is going to win 5-3. Jody and Harrison says 4-1. B.E. thinks that you should have a goldfish, Drew.
Well, it's probably more of my speed.
Yeah, slow.
Very.
Quite slow and golden and lives a very short life and might actually die before you're ready for it. No, I didn't go in that direction.
Make sure if you do get beta fish, you got to keep them separated. The males, they eat each other. I thought they were just playing.
Or if you put a mirror in front of it,
yeah.
it will
attack itself.
Bash yeah. its head to death. That's just what I've heard. I've never actually done that. Just PETA out there. These are things you hear on the internet.
Drew does this for fun.
I do not. Stop spreading lies.
Be very careful, because he might go on a rant and need another cold shower. All right, I'll be with you guys at 5:30 for the Dugout Show with Bubba, Arkansas, and Auburn, and then tomorrow we get to hash it all out here on Halftime. For Drew and Maddie, I'm Phil. Have a great rest of your Tuesday, and go Hogs. Get up, get out, and get better.